So I have VirtualBox installed on my Windows laptop. And VirtualBox works just fine. At least it used to. I could start VirtualBox and I could run virtual machines. And everything worked just as expected. But then I also installed WSL, Windows Subsystem for Linux, on the same computer. And as soon as I did that, VirtualBox stopped working. I mean, VirtualBox itself loads, but I can't start any virtual machine. And if I try to start a virtual machine, the virtual machine seems to be loading, but it really crawls. It can't be any slower. And after a long while, it seems to be starting to load. And eventually it gets to this splash screen. And the rotating circle rotates really slowly with pauses. And then after a while, it just stops. And that's as far as it gets. It never gets past this splash screen, and the virtual machine itself never loads. In some rare cases, the virtual machine eventually loads, but then it's so slow that it's just not usable. You just can't use it this way. So I googled this problem a bit, and I think that I found some sort of a workaround. So here is what I do. Let's open the Windows Features menu. And let's scroll down a bit. And after you install WSL, you will have this option turned on, Virtual Machine Platform. This is the option that prevents VirtualBox from working normally. So what I'm going to do is turn it off and click on OK. And then I need to restart the computer. So let's do that. Okay, so the computer was restarted. And if we open the Windows Features now, we can see that the virtual machine platform is turned off. Let's run VirtualBox now. And let's start our virtual machine. And now it works just fine. It loads immediately as if we never had any problem at all. And as you can see, the virtual machine is here and it's functional and it's working great. The only problem with this method has to do with WSL. So let's close the virtual machine. And let's open the Windows terminal. And if we try now to run the simplest WSL command, let's say WSL list. It fails to run, and we get this warning that says, please enable the virtual machine platform. So this is not a complete solution. You will not be able to run WSL and VirtualBox at the same time. But you will be able to easily switch between them by turning on or off this option from the Windows features. So if I now want to be able to use WSL again, all I have to do is open the Windows features again and turn on the virtual machine platform, and then WSL will be available, but VirtualBox won't be. So for the time being, that's the best solution I'm aware of. If you're aware of anything better, please let me know in the comments.